The first time that I was introduced to Michael Jackson, I didn't know it was Michael Jackson, and it was the first time I ever heard music. It was from the Destiny album, it was Shake Your Body Down to the Ground, the music. Let's dance, let's shout, shake your body down to the ground. That's the first thing. That's how I got introduced to music, and it happened to be Michael. I just didn't know what it was, but that sound, it stayed with me. And I heard other music, you know, after that, obviously, but even before I knew that that was Michael, whatever that was, whatever that voice was, that sounded like something that was completely different than anything I'd ever heard. The thing that inspired me to actually start doing tributes to Michael on stage was when I saw C.P. Lacey. He's actually the executioner at the Apollo. When I saw him doing that, I was amazed, because he didn't look like he was clowning or joking. He looked like he was really doing this whole interpretation of Michael, and I was blown away. I was like, I have to try that one day, and I did. I forget, you know, the whole issue of, oh, I'm a girl, and you know, they're gonna look at me like, oh my God, that's a woman. I forget about it sometimes because I get so engrossed in what I'm doing. But, you know, even when I'm on stage, you know, and then I talk to people later, they're like, we swore you were a guy. And then I can see people from the audience going, is that a guy or is that a girl? That's funny. On October 26, 2011, I had the privilege to be one of the performers who performed at the Super Top Dog competition at the Apollo Theater. And it was a great show overall. It really was. I had a chance to join a bunch of other Super Top Dog winners, including Michael, and you know, making history at the Apollo as, you know, one of the winners. And I actually, it was a split decision between me and another group. We split the prize money, you know, we split first place, but that was surreal to win that contest, because you know, Michael's won that contest, you know, and you know, so many other, you know, performers. It's a great feeling to be a part of that history, of the legacy of the Amateur Night competitions.
You know what I used to use? I used to use my shadow when I was growing up, because I didn't have a mirror. It wasn't until the first time I performed at the Apollo that I actually got a chance to see myself, see what I look like, because in the green room they have a big mirror. And I'd never seen myself before. I had to stop for a few minutes when I was down there practicing, because I'd always been accustomed to watching my shadow. When I actually had the luxury of a mirror, it was like, what's that?
I met Moses Harper. She was a friend of my friend Scott, and we were gonna plan to do some flash mobs throughout New York City. So we were like, well, we're gonna do Thriller, and this other group knew Beat It. And oh, by the way, I have a friend that does Michael Jackson, looks just like Michael Jackson, dances in Times Square, is a professional dancer. She's gonna join us. And I thought, wow, that's really cool, she should join us. She was fully decked out in her Beat It clothes, and It was a lot of fun. She found out about my organization, and just, she's always been supporting me ever since. Thrill the World is the worldwide team of fun-loving organizers. And what we're trying to do is break the world's largest simultaneous dance ever with Michael Jackson's Thriller. Every year at the same time, it's usually the weekend before Halloween, or it's during Halloween weekend. We will set a time that is to sync the world dance. You can go to www.thrilltheworldnyc.com and you can register, and you can learn the dance there as well.
We are the world, we are the children, we are the ones, make brighter day, so let's start giving.
Come on, Bernice, there's a choice we're making.
There's a choice we're making, yeah. We're saving our own lives.
take by the hand,
just you and me.